I don't know why it does that sometimes, but good morning. Welcome to DDOwiki Talk. I'm probably going to have to reset my chat once the raid completes. Here we go. Starting to come in now. Video stream is now hosting you with up to 5 viewers. Hope everybody's having a great morning. Let's close that really quick. Pop this back out. Video stream. Good morning, Javor. Just getting my screen organized here. There we go. I think we got that all set up. That's on my channel. Let's see if I can find the splash screen thing here. Splash screen. Okay. This up. Okay. Video streams offline. Figure out some notifications for the bot. There we go, so we got the notification for DDO stream. We're on episode 87 here. Good. Log in on the forums, I guess. Bring this up, we'll put Javor in it. J-A-V-O-O-R-H. That gives us 1 of 10. We're good to go there. Forums. This is the homepage for the wiki. Special pages, some stuff we could do there, but that's not my project for today. My project for today is to try to build a table of which items can accept sentience and be used for leveling up your sentient weapons. Here's our recent changes for the last week. We can actually take a look at those. Let's see here, December 11th, December 12th. Okay, so here's 10 o'clock. So we got some stuff on Template Talk Mythic we'll need to take a look at. talk false life. What we worked on stream. User talk Dipey. DIYPI, I don't know. Not really an acronym. It's just a bunch of letters. Some user stuff. Some spam block talk pages. The land of Barovia has had a lot of discussion. Take a look at that. A lot of new categories for the new template talk mythic. We already got that one open. Sealed in amber. Take a look at that one. Item talk epic eld edge. We'll take a look at that one. Weapon, epic weapons and crafted weapons. We'll take a look at that. I haven't seen that yet, I don't think. I think I overlooked it last time I went through. Spam blocks. Spam blocks. Mythic boost. Yeah, template talk mythic. Let's get the mythic boost page to go with it. Some stuff having to do with an invitation to dinner. And a Barovia. Talk page. Talk page. I like taking a look at the talk page stuff at the beginning of every DDOwiki talk to make sure there's nothing that I'm overlooking that I need to work on. Since I say it, I'll do a lot of things and then I forget about them, and if I don't check the talk pages, I won't know. Now this will make it so that I don't have to worry about that. Okay, so we turned Mythic into a meta template last week to be used with named item, which will now automatically add Mythic boost to all items unless it's overridden on the pages, item pages, Mythic faults based on what kind of item is using the formula from the Mythic boost page. Additional work is needed. Only items found in chests can be mythic, and rewards crafted items usually cannot. Check if chest is set. If not, don't add mythic. See also epic weapons and crafted weapons. We have that here. We'll drag that over. Take a look at that in a minute. The automatic behavior is not correct. I would suggest that the switch in template night item takes into account the type slot. Via that code. Good morning, Red Petey. How are you today? Add you to the giveaway here. Well, you must be in DDO stream channel. Yes, coffee and a life. Exactly, in that order. Let's add red here. Red PD. Done. Save. Good. Now we're 1/5 of the way there. Woo! Unfortunately, there's a mismatch between how mythic enchantment is called in the game and slot name. For example, gloves have mythic hand boosts, so I started to redesign template mythic under template crew lore, but cannot make it work. Feel free to mess around with it if you want. Too long, don't read. Check for chest. Redesign mythic to accept type slot. And second parameter would no longer be necessary. Update the switch as above, or so. Will checking for chest really work? I know there are pages out there where people have filled in chest upgraded version of item because they don't understand how templates work, something I hope to fix before too much longer. I can add type slot, as it is just another switch and shouldn't be too hard. If I do that, the existing parameter is no longer needed because the parameter is just a more refined version of what I'm using. So he says, I guess chest is not 100%, but at least filter some quests and rewards. And then Ulfold posted a new section. All waste items can have mythic weapon boosts. Not armor as currently. Neck items, on the other hand, can have armor, not weapon, as currently. Mythic is also showing up on store items. So we already went over that one. So we'll need to work on that. Yes. Yes, indeed. It means that you're in the database from the first 20 shows or so, where I've actually put all the names in the databases. I need to go through and update that at some point to add all the rest of the names. There's a lot more names that should automatically show up because they've watched before. Let me mute my phone so it doesn't get annoying. Alright, so template mythic, epic weapons and crafted weapons. All of the epic seem to have a mythic 204 parser. I do not think this is accurate. Here's an example. Seeing Crystal Cove and Kraneth crafted items. Mythic bonuses, I don't think they are possible to be created with mythic. Okay, so we're filtering everybody back into mythic, template mythic rework. Mythic boost. This is a new one. If there's a double entry, yes, I knew that that was going to show up. Tech rework, excellent. So everybody's being filtered back into there, that's good. Bring me some too. Okay, so everything's filtering back into here, good. Land of Barovia. Rod's journals, maps. Also worth noting, each journal can randomly appear in three locations. Is it that it can randomly appear in three locations, or there are three or more different maps with set locations for each? Let's ask. Is it really random? Okay, sealed in amber. Those are the monsters. Most of them don't exist yet. Epic Eld Edge. Where does it come from? Isn't this the one that you get from Red Fens? No. Sentinels, right? This is a Sentinel's rapier? And if it's a Sentinel's rapier, then I'm pretty sure it can proc with the mythic weapon boost when you epic it. I mean, if starter items can proc with it, why wouldn't epic items? Because it's literally creating a new item when you change it from base to epic. No different than creating a starter item in that aspect. People have seen starter items with it, so I wish I could get one of those starter items. Let's ask. Good morning, Todd. That's muted. Make sure this is online. Well, we'll post that there and we'll see what we get out of it. Let's have a look at Bernicio. Help improve tag. As far as I can tell, all this page needs is a crap screenshot to replace the existing headshot. Probably tag can probably be removed now. Headshot's probably preferred. I can't spell, so it's a good thing I have spell checks. I had a whole bunch of spell checks. There we go. Good. Good, good, good. Talk. Dragon marks. What's happened here? 2013, 2014. Confirmed. Help does not list show dragon mark in the list of possible commands. Okay. So this we should, you know. There's no Sivirus mark of scribing. The rash should be updated to a higher resolution image, but why is that rolling over like that? Let's take a look at that. Let's make them. How many are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Let's make them 80 px. 80 by 80. There we go. Should we reorder them? Those file names should be updated. With what the dragon mark is. Dragon mark of healing, dragon mark of making, dragon mark of passage, etc. Let's move these and get this done. Right, Sentinel, Dragon Mark of Shadow. Dragon Mark of Warding. Dragon Mark of Finding. Dragon Mark of Scribing. Don't have a no pick? Oh, I can't do that there. There we go. That looks better. Pause notifications for that. I don't want Facebook notifications. Okay, history, lore. Supposed to be a note that help doesn't show the thing there. I don't know. All right, so what we're going to work on? Table. So let's create a sandbox. Sentient weapons. DPL. Alright, so let's see if we can create a table based on what we know about sentient weapons. first thing to do. DPL. Category. Not category. Let me see if I can bring up the documentation for that. Hopefully the documentation's working today. Okay. We got category. And list multiple categories. And we have not category. Which you can have multiple listings for not categories. Okay, so you can do multiple not categories in succession, and for category they go broken by pipe. That's kind of annoying, but whatever. Okay. So let's start with this. Let's open a page, and we're going to go with category items to start with, because I don't know what the category structure is that I want to use. So we do have a category weapons, so that's where we should start. Anything that's in category weapons. Let's start with category weapons. Okay, we'll move this down here for now. Everything in category weapons. So that's a complete list of weapons. Excellent. So, what weapons are excluded from that? Well, we know we have... Well, let's take Energized Warhammer, for example. That's a template, Temple of Elemental Evil item, right? Yes. Okay, so any weapon that is part of... upgradable item Temple of Elemental Evil items. So let's filter out Temple of Elemental Evil items. Okay. That looks good. We'll also need to add we don't want anything level 1 to 19 to be in there. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. Level 20 is acceptable, I believe. Okay. Okay, so I should be able to drag this up there. And that'll filter out anything below level 20. Where does that put us? Why are these starters still showing up? Did I get the category name wrong? Minimum level. Oh, they're minimum level weapons, not items. Okay. We can fix that. So this should be weapons. Now let's show preview. Boom. Suck all that stuff out. Okay, what else is not acceptable? Looks like that's working. Category exotic weapons. So I need to filter by namespace, make sure it's in the item namespace. How do I filter by namespace? So based on namespace. So namespace equals. Namespace equals item. That should filter out the category ones. Excellent. What else do we have? Thunderforge. So let's take a look at a Thunderforge. Let's filter those out. Magma Forge loot, Thunderforged items. We'll go with Thunderforged items so that it's clear that everybody knows that that's what they are. Okay, so where does that get us? Earth Carver and Earth Carver shards. So those are bound to quest items, right? So anything that drops on death or drops on leaving adventure, right? So we need to filter out those items. Should we add drops on death as well? I don't know if there's anything that drops on death that doesn't drop on leaving adventure. So there's 21 pages here. And 30 pages here. So if I open both of these, right? And I go through and I click on all of the drops on death items. Make them dark blue. Right, if I do that, so they're all dark blue, and then I switch over to, I can close them all now. I have no other purpose other than make the links blue. Now if I take a look here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21. So they're all here, plus a few others. So this one is all inclusive of the other one, plus extras. Excellent. So that'll take care of that. We need to filter out. Broccoli bashers. That was one of the anniversary event items. It's not crafted, is it? So it should be fair game. What was I gonna do? Oh. Sentient base item? Well, let's just go to sentient weapon. Base item should be transcluded in there anyway. Eligible weapons. Minimum level 20 or higher. Crafted, upgraded, mostly Temple of Elemental Evil, Legendary Green Steel, which don't show up in the list anyway, and Thunderforge. So anything that's an offhand isn't acceptable. We'll take a look at these two pages. This note, this list includes crafted weapons that might be ineligible. So we're going to take a look at that. We're going to take a look at ineligible as well. So, Earth Carver Shard is ineligible. It drops upon leaving the Earth Carver. That's where I picked that up from. So there are items for Green Steel. Okay, we need to take a look at that one. What categories does it have? Legendary Green Steel items. Okay, so we'll grab that category, filter that one out. Ah, there they are. Okay, so we'll filter those out. Ineligible weapons. So, Grave Reppings, Antipode, and the level 20 and 24 versions should be flagged with accept sentience and aren't. This should be fixed in upcoming patch. Adamantine Knuckles do not accept sentience. Why do Adamantine Knuckles not accept sentience? Let's edit this page, actually. Let's link these weapons. So Grave Wrappings, item, Antipode, item, item, Adamantine Knuckles, item, Frostbite Blade, Spectral Dagger, many items seemingly auto do not, Thunder and Lightning. So we're going to, okay, so level 27 for that, and that, okay. Show preview. Antipode, I'll need to look up. There's no page for that yet, I'll need to look that up. So search for this and other items. I don't see it listed anywhere else. So we don't have pages for those? We don't seem to have anything on that at all. That's not helpful. I know there's an antipode, but it's Fist of the Horizon. Okay. I got that one. Commendation sets. I don't see any hand wraps here. So how about we do, I don't know, category, minimum level 24 weapons, see if it shows up there. Yeah, I'm still not seeing anything. Raps of, I don't know. I don't know what that's from. But whatever. Mountain's Fist. Let's link that one. I almost missed that one. I know the Mountain's Fist exists. Name's just a little bit off. The Mountain's Fist. It's got the in front of it. Okay. Spectral Dragon Dagger, level 20 version. We don't have a page on. All right, we'll save that. 9 a.m. Excellent. Quiet crew this morning. Okay, Frostbite blade, breaking the ice. Let's take a look at the ML28 version. Could probably dump the mythic weapon boost items category. But we'll leave it for now. No reason that shouldn't be, that I can see. Mountain's Fist. Maze of Mire, Madness, and Trial by Fire. Spectral Dagger. Being an event item, I can almost see that one not working. But if there are other event items, then it should work. Adamantine Knuckles. So it seems to be the ones that have multiple augment slots aren't working either. So I might need to do some work to the weapon template to have it detect when multiple augment slots exist. Because that's one thing I see in common with some of these items. Antipode. Attuned to heroisms of crafting. So, but if other ones work, then it should work. Equips to main hand. Not an issue with that. Min level 23, it's not an issue with that. I don't know. It's got a crafting system on it, as far as I'm concerned, but... Min level 20, main hand, could be taint of evil. So soul leading doesn't Manflit Slayer overrides soul leading. Thunder and lightning. On this one, it could be the unusual attack or damage mod. But we'll go with this for now. I think that's a pretty good start. So how do we want to display this information? Right now we just have a list, but I want to make a table out of it. So... how do we make a table out of it? Uses template named weapon. Table. name, ML. I don't know if I want to put the effects on it because we really don't care what the effects are. We care about the name, we care about the minimum level. We care about where it drops. Let's get rid of uses. Get rid of that. Okay. That's all done with NCL. Named item category? Nope. Named items category. I always forget that S for some reason. So I need include. I need an include. So we have item, we want, care about those pieces of information, we want minimum level and quests. Table sort call, if it's got a sort, we don't need that at all. That's bloat. Okay, so we're making some progress. Named weapon doesn't template name weapon. So let's take a look at template named weapon. So it's not called named weapon. What is it called? Oh, capital W. Let's try capital W. Named weapon. That didn't fix it either. Okay. Okay. So we have min level. And quest. Page selection variables, copy, paste. Oh, I missed your comment, Javor. Let's see here. In epic crafting, you can only use greater tokens. I don't remember how that system all works. So that's not what I want. Output format. This is what I want. Okay. Table. Controlling output format. It's not the one I want. I want other parameters. I don't remember. Let's just go with include. There we go. That's what I want. So include. Template colon thing colon thing. Okay, so template. There's a colon for the first one, right? Yep. Colon thing, colon thing. Is there a colon in the last one? No. Why isn't it picking up those? You know what? We're not going to do it that way. We're going to do this. Sentient Phantom. hidden T sentient phantom. That's right. So we're gonna do, wait, why isn't sentient phantom showing up? Oh, because I did it wrong. It's supposed to be this, this. Show preview. Now it should show up right there. Okay, good. Let's start with this. Make sure that's going to work the way that I want. Phantom template doesn't exist. I'm going to go with this. And grab my no include, my include only. Good. Okay, so don't need this. Okay, so build is minimum level. The next field is quest. The next field should be min level 20 How does that work again? Sentient weapon. Okay, here it is. So expression 20 times switch. Minimum level 20 equals 1. 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27 equals 5. 28, 29, 30 doesn't exist yet, but we're going to add 31, 32, 33, 34 equals 10. Default equals 1. Okay. We'll go with this. What do I got now? Twenty plus unknown expression. I didn't close out my expression properly. So I have expression, min level 20, switch. I closed out the switch, but I forgot to close out the expression. Minor edit. I should move XP in, put quest on the end. Let's do that. Move XP in. Let's edit the phantom for that. Quest on the end. Okay, save page. What if I change this? For some reason, named weapon isn't working. How about if I use named item? Does that fix it? There we go. Minimum level, XP. Why is XP so wide? Oh, so I need to fix Ember repeating light crossbow. Not the only one? Nope. Fintan's bite needs to be fixed. Minimum level can't be no. That one needs to be fixed. Oath of Drome shouldn't be showing up, should it? Isn't that one a drop? Yeah, special quest. So it needs a bind status for it. Edit. Edit. So, repeating light crossbow, edit. So it's okay, so why is this even showing up in the table? It's a no min level weapon. We need to filter this out. I thought I already had that filtered out, but okay. Scepter of Sibrews, we need to fix that one. Snowball, fix that one. Fix Wayfinder Scepter. That's supposed to be filtered out, not category. We'll see. What's this one? That's another one of those gnomon level ones. Maybe I had it typed wrong. Holodrins is gnomon level. Oathodrome. Drops on leaving adventure. So that one shouldn't be in there. Scepter of Sibiris. Gnomon level, that shouldn't be in there. Snowball, gnomon level, that shouldn't be in there. No. Okay. There we go. That fixes all of those. There's a little typo in there. All right, let's start with, let's see what our starting point looks like. It's 9:30. Let's get a new cup of coffee. I think we're making some progress here. So you can sort by minimum level, which also sorts by XP, kind of. I think that looks really, really good for a start. Only I'm wondering if I should make a double table there. Make a table on top for everything that you can't apply sentience to. Although I guess it's not really important. Well, I don't know. Maybe a list of fodder items is good. Although I think that's a separate set of criteria. So I think we're at a good point here for this table. Although we can add more to it, as far as restrictions and whatnot. So those are by 10s, excellent. Get up to 27, those are by 5s, excellent. I like the way that that looks. Oh, wait a minute, we got Temple of Elemental Evil Part 1 stuff in there. Let's take a look at that one. Why is that showing up? So it shows up as Part 1 root, Part 2 root. I don't care about the Phantom, but I do care about back to top, edit. So it doesn't have the upgradable item component to it. Okay, that's why. So let's just filter it by part one loot or part two loot. We'll make that adjustment instead. So for this one, we'll go part one and part two. We'll go with that. And that should filter out those. What else do we have? Do we want to be able to sort by quest? So the ones where quest is empty are all scroll seal shard system. I want to take a look at one of those. See if I can figure out how to make that work. Breaking the Ice, Legend Revisited, Lesson of Assaults. Ooh, Slave Lords. Is that something that is usable? Isn't it a crafting system? No, it's just a set bonus, okay. But we do need to edit that and fix the the double thing there. Doesn't need this anymore. It's already got it. Baked in, man. Baked in. Okay, so I got this. Okay. Good. Epic luminous truth. Let's see here. I don't know what we're going to do with those. Let me see, is there some kind of category I can use for those? If it's in this category, or if it's got this feature. Web of Chaos Epic Items. So if it's in an epic item subcategory, I don't know if I can filter by that though. I could do links too. Maybe. What does the page link to? Nope, there's nothing for that in this page already. So I'll have to go through and do some work to those pages. Okay. That's fine. Black and blue, breaking the ranks, caught in the web stuff. Devil, demon assault, defiler, desire that in the dark. Epic crafting. See, that was a manually set category. Although epic crafting isn't really crafting as far as internally is concerned. Legendary signs of supply, Lost in the Swamp, Maybar Endless Night Festival, Epic Dice and Slice, Outbreak, Overgrowth, Palace of Stone, Rest Stop. Anything else here is what I'm looking for. Giant Tor, Prison of the Plain, Sands, Strike Back, Subversion, Crucible, Curse of Strahd, Druid's Curse, Fall of Truth, House of Broken, Rusted, Houses of Maze of Madness, Night Revels. Maze of Madness, Mountain's Fist. Okay. Those might not show up. And I should do something for multiple slot augment slots. Tower of Frost, Crystal Cove. Unknown. So there's unknown in a lot of those epic, old epic items. Vaults of the Artificers. Are those things usable? I don't know. Thundering Lightning. So I think that's a good start. Okay, so the only thing left here that I want to do is I want to, let's see here, data sort type number. I want to center the numbers for XP and I believe I have a class of center set. Let's take a look at that and see if it works. It does not. So I'm going to have to do style text align center, I guess, because I don't have a table cell center set. You know what? I'm going to add a table cell center if it doesn't exist. Okay, so that was before the data sort type. We'll put that there. Quests. Okay, so we'll save page here. We'll edit the phantom. I want the quest to link to the quest page. Although maybe I should right align that one. So left align, centered, right align. So quest should be linked. If it, I don't want to if existed. What I'll do is if equals quest, it's empty, do this, otherwise link the quest. It's empty, then I want to have an error. Unknown. There, we'll go with that. And next thing to do is we're going to actually copy this. Nope, we're not going to do that. We're going to leave it just the way it is. I decided I wasn't going to do that. Okay. So I can actually delete those lines. And I was going to class equals write. Now we'll do a style on that one. Style equals text align write. PPL, pop one of those in there. Back to here. Blue water in, huh? At the crafting. Okay. Why isn't it aligning right? Should it be left? That doesn't seem right to me. Yeah, that doesn't change anything. Why isn't it aligning? Oh. No. Oh, it is aligning up here. It's not aligning down there. That's why. Okay, so I need to fix the phantom for that. That's why. Okay. So it's going to be... class equals... center class equals center style equals text align right. We need to add Okay, let's take a look at this one real quick. So I can remember what I wanted to do. I'm going to copy this. I don't really see a use for that, actually. Somebody else can't spell either. It's not a list, it's a table. I would like that. This one does have DPL cache, good. That's going to go on the top, DPL cache. Sentient weapon base items. Add to my dictionary. Add to my dictionary. Good. Save page. I can't delete the page, but I can move it in shortly. Take this one. Need to fix that phantom. Don't need this open. That phantom. Why did that break? Class center 20 style. Let's take a look. Oh, because I forgot my pipes. Okay. It's pipes. Good. Perfect. Now, open up a new tab in Firefox, drag that sucker over. Let's grab this up here. Stretch this out like this. There we go. Let's go to this page. Copy back to top. Move page. To main space, sentient weapon, okay, can't move that yet until I delete this, so let's delete this page. making room for move. Delete page. Okay. Move page in. Page. Delete page. Forming a history merge. Delete page. Viewer restore 13 edits. Performing a history merge. Restore all revisions. Has been restored. Excellent. So now, page history. I know it's hard to see this here. All the revisions are there. Excellent. Sentient base weapons. Excellent. Sortable as well. Perfect. Now let's edit this page. Let's include only this section. Or only include it, rather. That'll only be included. Let's make sure this only shows up MW lapsed when we do this. So we're going to set up inclusion rules. Go back to sentient weapon. Go to sentient feed. Where is it? It's not what I want. I want right here. Eligible weapons. And we're going to include the sentient weapon base item page. Perfect. This isn't showed to most people. They can expand the table or collapse it. Put a bullet on this one and make it bold. Save page. Expand. Excellent. All right, so when I upload this to YouTube, I will make note that the wiki now has a mostly accurate table of which items can gain sentience, or which items should be able to gain sentience based on the information that we have. Where to acquire them, and how much XP you can get for each one. We've got 5 minutes left of the stream. Unfortunately, we only got up to 3 out of 10 chatters today. So it's not even close to being able to do the drawing. Yes, Psy indeed. We had Javor, Red PD, and Todd. Says I currently have one viewer. Let's see, what do we got here? It says, what does this say? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 lurkers. There's enough people lurking that could say hi in the next 5 minutes for us to do the drawing on the DDO stream channel. On my personal channel, let's see here. There's at least, well, there's only one lurker there, so. If you're lurking in the channel, say hi. Nobody? All right. So that was our project for today. That was what I really wanted to get done. Let me post on Discord. Alrighty. Let's post this DDO stream channel. Got to do the formatting. Discord, indeed. You'll note that apparently the people of the stream aren't important enough to be able to contribute to this channel, so whatever. As far as I'm concerned, there are a bunch of bullies on that server anyway, so I won't personally join there. But whatever, it's all good. And you know what? I think I'm going to post in the the Freeno channel as well, even though it's rarely used at this point. Excellent. Not specifically. Although she's probably the biggest one. So, and I wasn't personally bullied, but I saw a lot of other people being bullied, and then the staff wouldn't stick up for them. So I said, yeah, well, being co-owner of this server, if I don't have any say over, you know, whether or not staff sticks up for people being bullied, I won't hang out there. So. I've had quite a few people message me suggesting that I create my own Discord DDO server, where bullying won't be tolerated by anyone, regardless of their status. So, I might do that at some point. I don't know. I don't really have a lot of interest in it at the moment. I'm currently quite busy running the Locho server, which is doing pretty well. Over 1,000 members that are active, that have actually said something in channel. Anyway, it's 10:01, 10:02. So that's the end of the stream for today. Let's refresh our recent changes to see what we actually accomplished today. Special pages can be refreshed. Land of Barovia. Getting a lot of edits. That will need to be patrolled. Take care of that in a moment. Looks like we did some talk on Land of Barovia, top on Epic Eldedge. Clean that up, get rid of the needs work. Do a little bit of copy editing on the drawing on the face section there. Sentient weapons, ineligible weapons. Link items that exist on wiki. Remove mythic boost, automatically added now. We created a phantom template to populate our DPL table on our sentient weapon base item page. Sentient weapons, we cleaned out the eligible weapons section and put the table right on the page in a collapsed state. Quite a bit done today. I think we did a good job. And that will wrap it up for today's DDOwiki talk. I will be posting this episode as well as last week's on YouTube shortly. Next Tuesday is December 26th. Being it's the day right after Christmas, I do not anticipate that I will be on. So there will be no giveaway next week. The week after, January 2nd, I will be out of state. There will be no DDOwiki talk on January 2nd. So I should be, well, January 9th, I still probably won't be back from Oklahoma. So the next DDOwiki talk is probably not going to be until January 16th. There was none today. We didn't get enough people. We only got 3 of 10. We only hit 30%. So, next DDOwiki talk will be January 16th. Thank you for watching. Actually, Let me check one thing first. I think I still have a starter pack left. Let me check. Okay, so it looks like I have one starter pack and three DDO point packs left. So if we hit 25 chatters, I'll give away a starter pack. If we hit at least 10, 500 DP point code. So that's, we'll do that. Have a great week, everybody. Merry Christmas. Happy New Year's.